So let's build up to the answer in steps. We know that if n equals 1, it just returns a single node. If n equals 2, it's going to recursively generate a single node for G1, a single node for G2, then randomly choose nodes from those sets, which in this case are just the only nodes that are there, so it'll choose them, and then it connects them up. So that's what n equals 2 looks like. For n equals 4, we have two n equals 2s, right? G1 and G2 are both going to be an n equal 2 graph. Let me draw those. Then it's going to randomly choose one of the nodes and one of the nodes and connect them up. So far, it looks kind of like a chain in all these cases. Let's go to the next case. Again, for n equals 8, it has to generate n equals 4 graphs, each of which has to generate a bunch of n over 2 graphs, which all look like this. There's going to be some randomness about how they get connected up. So it could be maybe in one of the times we call it, we get something like this, and one of the times we get something like this. Then we connect randomly the two n equals 4 graphs to get the n equals 8 graph, and maybe that'll be something like this. So in this particular case now, we don't have a chain anymore. We do, on the other hand, have a tree. And in fact, this property continues. As we get bigger and bigger graphs, we're always connecting up some kind of tree structure with some other kind of tree structure. I'll draw another one. And we connect up these two tree structures, and that just gives us a bigger tree structure. So we get a nice, messy, recursively defined tree, but it's still a tree.